Hey, what's up everybody? This is Thomas from the team GadMode. Let's review Sony Xperia XA Ultra. There are two smartphone manufacturing giants who seem to be consistently failing in understanding the market trend. One being Microsoft and the other is Sony. XA Ultra is one such example. Though the device has a lot of positive points, still it fails to cope up to the basics that a user looks for at this price range of 23,000 after the huge price drop. Let's check the box content and in the meanwhile let's turn on the device so that it boots. And by the time let's see the accessories. Box contains the charger, USB cable, earphones, warranty card and user manuals. Charger surprisingly supports fast charging and Sony claims 10 minutes of charge can provide up to 5.5 hours of usage. The other side of the box provide details of made in China and IMEI number details and specifications and MRP details available behind the box. Let's quickly wrap up the box content and let's see about the display, one of the major plus of this device. It's a 6-inch full HD edge-to-edge viewing which is encased in a razor thin frame and bit of curve at the corners provide a great viewing experience. Display looks bright and colorful and even though it's 6-inch big, it does not feel so big and it fits very well in the hand. Talking about build and its quality, where it seems like Sony failed in its approach. Bottom of the device consists of speaker grill, USB charging port and a primary noise cancellation port. Speaker output is not loud enough but manageable and decent enough. Top of the device has a 3.5mm audio jack and provides a very good quality output. There is a secondary noise cancellation port as well. Now looking at the sides of the device, there is a SIM card and memory card tray section. When you open the window, you can see there is a dedicated memory card slot as the inbuilt memory is just 16GB and accepts up to 200GB of expandable storage. There is a dual nano SIM slot and accepts 4G LTE band. The other side of the device has a dedicated camera shutter button, volume rockers and a power button in classic Sony style. Backside of the device hosts a charm of the device. There is camera, 21.5 megapixel camera through which you can expect high class performance even in low light. There is a dual LED flash neatly placed underneath the camera lens. Front top has the Sony logo placed in the center and the left side of it has notification LED along with sensor and the right side has 16MP camera along with dual LED flash and there is nothing at the bottom. Navigation buttons have been set on screen. Now coming to the software features, which is one of the classical form which Sony has consistently maintained in the Xperia series from a long time but with a lot of improvisations. Sony has completely customized the Android OS and Xperia UI customizations starting from the icons of the default applications as well. You can see the same layout on any Xperia series of Sony. App drawer are available which cannot be found in most of the Chinese devices now. Sony opts to stay in its classical way of approach. Let's see the settings of the device. Every single setting option has been represented with Sony's customized icons. About the phone section shows all information about the phone software and hardware specifications. This device comes out with Android Marshmallow or version 6.0. and also promises Nougat or version 7.0 very soon. Swiping down from the top provides quick setting and notification panel which retains more of stock Android OS design and Sony has not tried customizing this particular section. Gallery has a lot of viewing customization options. Just by pinching in or zooming, icons can be enlarged or shrunk. Layout dynamically arranges the photos with multiple viewing options. This becomes pretty unique option available in Xperia UI and may become handy while you are trying to search a particular photo in the list of photos in gallery. Let's see some more customization options available. Lock screen and security wise, it has some basic options as the fingerprint sensor is not available in the device. Sony is still struggling to provide a perfect place for a fingerprint sensor. Till now, even in their flagship devices, few of the top-end devices uses the power button itself as a fingerprint sensor, however found to be inaccurate at times. One-handed operation becomes mandatory in this type of large screen devices, and Sony doesn't lag behind in developing such options. Just swipe from the left or right edge of the screen and screen size shrinks for one-handed operation. Since the navigation buttons are also on screen or software buttons, it becomes more easier to reach the shrinked screen completely. Let's see the most important aspect or focused feature of the device, camera. As said, front camera is a 16 megapixel shooter with optical image stabilization and is expected to perform pretty well in low light conditions, as it also has dual LED flash, and the primary camera hosts a 21.5 megapixel hybrid autofocus sensor to track the objects accurately. There is a clear visible shutter lag when you click a picture and is not pretty fast to quickly take a photo. User interface is pretty clean and covers a bundle of options to satisfy photography needs. Swiping the left hand side to quickly toggle between manual mode, video mode, auto mode, etc. There is a bundle of customization options as you can see for manual mode, which cannot be seen in this price range in any of the devices. Sony has worked a lot on these customizations and it's clearly visible. There are also a few camera inbuilt applications provided by Sony, like AR effect or augmented reality effect, sound photo, face in picture, creative effect, and many more applications can be downloaded from Sony store by clicking on add option. Let's quickly see some samples captured from the primary camera before we end up the review. Photos come natural and accurate in color reproduction without saturating or decorating much and feels great while viewing in an edge-to-edge display like this. Overall, Sony has delivered an imperfect smartphone with a cost which makes the buyer think twice before buying it. However, if you are looking for a good camera with a big display, this is the phone that will embrace you. Do let us know your view, give it a thumbs up if you like the video, and do consider sharing the video with your friends. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel for more such wonderful, unbiased tech reviews coming soon. Stay tuned, bye-bye.